A new charter too, from a distance in blood banking. It's called compatibility and cross-matching. As we know earlier, that in blood banking, when a person needs a blood transfusion, it's no longer enough to match a person, a recipient blood with a donor blood. For example, if a recipient is A positive and a donor is A positive, we cannot automatically transfuse this person with this person. Because even though they match 100%, we still have to go one step further to make sure not only this blood of the donor blood and the recipient blood match, but we need them to be what's called compatible. In another word, when we transfuse the RBCs of the donor to the patient, we have to make sure that the patient's serum does not have an antibody, it's called alloantibody, unexpected antibody against one of the 400 antigens on the donor blood. Well, I'm not talking about anti-A or anti-B, these are expected. Now, maybe the donor blood has this antigen, for some strange reason, this recipient's plasma has an antibody against this antigen for some maybe previous transfusion, for some reason. So we have to make sure that the RBCs transfused to the recipient will live for at least, you know, for have a long longevity in the patients and not being destroyed by an antibody, an alloantibody or an unexpected antibody in the recipient blood. For this reason, we do what's called cross-matching. We do what's called cross-matching. If you can see it here, cross-matching. We take the donor's red blood cells and our method recipient plasma. Now, actually, recipient serum, not plasma. Make sure it's the recipient serum. Now, the donor's red cells and the recipient serum. Now, if this is A positive, we match it with A positive. Well, we know these match, but we have to look for an unexpected antibody in the serum against one of those 400 different antigens that we do not normally routinely test for. Make sure the recipient, we don't use the plasma, we use the serum, because in the plasma there is usually an anticoagulant which chelate calcium that prevent activation of complement if existed. So we use serum. We use what? Serum. Now, what do we do? This is exactly what we do. Now, two tubes, we labeled as patient name, home, labeled as control. The reason we need the control, we only have one tube only. If it is a positive, but there is no other negative here, we have to make sure that's really, really positive, not because of the red cells are coated with protein, or it's called, as I told you before, instantaneous agglutination. So, patients and control. First, we put two drops of patient serum
patient here, what a patient mean recipient. And two drops of what? Yes, you guessed it, 20% albumin. Well now, in order for the test to be valid, the control has always be negative. This is first. Second, two drops of donor's cells, and here, two drops of donor's cells. Second or third spin, centrifuge, gently dislodge and look for agglutination. So, this phase, you know exactly what to do. Now, what do we get? First, results. A, patient control. A positive, negative. Negative control means that the patient does not have the RBC, or the patient does not have, or does not cover with a protein, with the protein is not instantaneously, is not instantaneously clotted or agglutinated, means there is an antibody. That's why it's positive. There must be an antibody in the patient's serum, against one of those antigens on RBC. This is, we say, not compatible. So we cannot transfuse this patient with those donors, even though it's matched, even though it matches, A positive and A positive. But since the cross-matching is positive, is what? Positive, we cannot transfuse this. We have to look for another patient that give us a negative cross-match. B, positive. Positive, no. Interpretation, most likely the patient has, because why would the control be positive? Control has to be negative. No interpretation, most likely the patient RBC is called, is coated with cold agglutinin or maybe a huge amount of protein. Third, C, negative, negative. Here, since it is negative, we do not automatically consider it as well it is compatible. It could be negative, but the cells is sensitized. Remember what we did last week or the week before? It could be negative. It looks like this. Or it could be negative and it looks like this. There is an alloantibody here, but there is no agglutination. We call this, yes, what do you call this?
Sensitized
cell. So if it's positive, we stop. It is not compatible. If it is no agglutination, we have to make sure that the antibody is not, is maybe IgG, it does not, is it sensitized the cells, but it does not agglutinate.
We have to go into what's called anti-human globulin or Coombs test. In this case, here goes to go to anti-human globulin test. We use anti-human globulin, اللي هو anti-D.
AHG.
AH. Yeah, anti-human globulin test. Use anti-human globulin. Use anti-human globulin. Which we did it when we did the D, Zecro, the DU and D. First, incubate the cells, both control and patient, 10 minutes. At 37 degrees, the spin positive, stop, no, not compatible, compatible, negative, here, wash the cells 3 times, add anti-human globulin, spin, look for agglutination. Positive, not compatible, negative, compatible. Here, when it's negative, every time we have test anti-human globulin, we use anti-human globulin. If it's negative, we have to use the CCC or check cells to see if anti-human globulin is working. That's all. The CCC to see if the anti-human globulin is working. So this is, in short, what's compatibility and cross-matching. Basically, for compatibility, in order for the patient and the donor to be compatible, they should have, the recipient should have no antibody that might against any of the antigens, 400 antigen RBC, that might lyse the antigens, and we have an immune reaction, non-transfusion reaction. Thank you.